We'll start this. My name is Prashant Sawant, most of you know, but others who don't know, I have been taking seminars here for many years now. So today we are going to talk on money magic and how we can manifest more money. So if you see this word money, so do you see any other word is M-O-N-E-Y? Any other word inside that big word? Honey, no, honey, H is not there. The letters which are there, like...
If you add K, then it will be monkey.
A monkey, okay, okay. But nothing like honey, one Baba manufactured honey. And the mother Baba's honey made sure that he went to jail. So honey can be dangerous also and good also. It depends on what is the application. So here, if you have to use only these letters, M-O-N-E-Y, any other word you can incur out of this? Take it out of any other word you can see. No, K will be there. Na? So K is not at the top. Remove as it is top. So that's what I always keep on thinking, what this word may have inside in the main word. So here it is my one. So if you go to anybody's wedding, we give 501. Why like that? Why we can't give round figure? But why like that? We could have given 499. This will continue. The new beginning. Like if you see some movies, the movie is over, they say to be continued. Part 2, Gangs of Vasipur kind of. So this is actually money is supposed to be increasing. So my one, it is my one. So see, there are so many things which we sometimes make mistakes and the money goes. First thing is money is about, paisa is about soch. Person has to be thinking rich, he will be rich. If you see B.R. Chopra, he came from Pakistan. With nothing. His family came nothing. Like, Mehra Sahab also much, we have come from. You came from Pakistan only? They were. Even Kapoor family, Dilip Kumar and Raj Kapoor, Prithviraj Kapoor, everybody was. Like, Rishi Kapoor that day tweet, nah, I want to go to my, where I was born and, you know, Pakistan. So, this has to, like, B.R. Chopra came with nothing. But his mindset was rich. So, again, he became rich here. He joined as started a journalist and again he became rich. So if you look, the thinking has to be rich. If you see the movie, I always give example of movie. So in Munna Bhai, in the movie Munna Bhai, if you remember the first part, Munna Bhai MBBS, where the dean, he insults his father and his father is asked to go and his father cries and all that. And in the night they are drinking in the dhobi ghat. And that day, that time Sanjay Dutt says ki doctor ki izzat hoti hai, baki kisi ki izzat hai hi nahi. And maybe doctor banega. So then circuit says, kya banega? Doctor banke kya karega bhai? Bolta hai, doctor banega, chinki se chadi karega. Aur rasta na kabhi dikha dega ki main kya. And then what he says is very important. He says, circuit, pata kar. Ye Bombay ka sabse top ka medical college kaun sa hai? See, that is a mindset. Top ka college. Just imagine, if you want to be doctor by hook and crook, you will say, koi bhi college mein ghuste hai, chote mode college mein, kaisa bhi karke nikal jate. Why I should go to the top college? But his thinking was, I should have top. If you see Karan Johar's movies, they are rich. Every frame, everything he does is rich and they attract money. Because the more they spend, more it will come. If we have taken those laws, law of giving. Law of giving is law of receiving. It is same. People think if I don't give, I will receive. But they cannot receive if they don't give. So like every frame of Karan Johar is rich. Even you can take the curtain, the carpet, everything, he wants the best. Like when Sanjala Bansali also. If you see K. Asif also, who made Mughal-e-Azam, nobody could, there was no producer who could pay that kind of money. So who came in to rescue? Who was the producer of, please come. Mera Sahab. He was never a producer, he only produced this movie. Because no other producer could have handled that kind of finance. Because we would have required 10 producers to make that movie. Shapurji Balanji funded this movie. This movie, the shooting went on for 10 years. And he spent money like water. And his son used to scrape always, ki, what you are doing, you know, he is just taking the money and I don't know what he is doing, movie is not getting complete. But Shapurji told all his people in his office that I trust that man. And whatever money he is asking, give. It is not a business. I am just doing it for fun. And I want the movie to be the top. It should be remembered for next 100 years. So whatever money is required, I am there. And K. Asif lived like a poor chap. His clothes used to be torn. He used to live in a small kind of hut. But he was absolutely zero in terms of his own grandeur, but the movies were very grand. He was very close to Dilip Kumar, and Dilip Kumar's sister ran with him. And then they fought and all. And he never spoke to that sister of his. And when she was on the deathbed, she called. This is what it is. In fact, K. Asif also left. K. Asif was already married. When he married, anyway, this is a big, like Dilip Kumar's biography, you should read where all these things are there. So here you are saying that K. Asif used to not spend a single money on himself, like nothing on himself, but the sets and everything was very lavish. So his vision was very grand. Likewise, the money, the thinking, if it is grand, people will again become rich. You must have seen people getting a lot of money and again becoming poor, because their mindset is poor. And people who are very rich, they become poor, but again they become rich, like Amitabh. In 1990, he was zero. Even his this bungalow was, Canara Bank was about to take it, Anil Ambani and that other guy, Amar Singh and all those people somehow saved him. But Amitabh again became rich because thinking was rich. It is like kind of thermostat in the AC. Suppose you set it at 22 degrees. So whatever happens, it will give 22 degree air. So tomorrow the heat goes up to 24, it will bring it to 22. And it goes to 18, it will again bring it to 22. And same thing, if you ask yourself what you have earned in last year, unfortunately, that is where your thermostat is set. And you will always earn, if you are earning 100 rupees, you will be in 90 and 110. And people say, why I am not growing? Why I am stagnating? Because their thermostat is 100. They will never become 200. They will never attract money. Because the basic problem is to attract what you want. Currently, suppose somebody is earning 100 and if he wants 200, he has to believe that he is worth 200. And there is one principle called act as if. Act as if. So if you are acting as if you are worth 100 and you are expecting 200, it is nonsense. It will never come. So when people start working as if they have 200 in their pocket, the money will come. Now it is dicey. No, they have to be, they have to behave like they are having a lot of money, but in fact they don't have. But if somebody has that conviction that yes, it is going to come, and I will spend as if I have that money, they will get it. Like you see, there are a lot of cases in the Hindi industry also. Like Firoz Khan actually put everything on stake when he made Kurbani. If Kurbani had gone down, he would have been on the roads. And same Kurbani time, there was one more movie which was also very big and people were expecting that movie to be a big competition to Kurbani. That was Curse. Curse. And Curse flopped badly because of Kurbani. And after Curse, Rishi Kapoor went into depression. In his biography, he has written, he went into depression because he was so sure that Curse will be a game changer and it flopped badly. And today, whenever the movie is running on the TV, everybody stops and they watch the movie. It has become a cult movie. Raj Kapoor put everything on stake when he made Mera Naam Joker. He was broke. He was totally in, he didn't have any money left with him. And then he made Bobby with hardly any budget. And he recovered everything back in Bobby. And the money spent on Bobby was say 10 rupees. And Mera Naam Joker, he had wasted 250 rupees, for example. And it went bad. So the mindset is like that, he will get it. So that is what I want to say. So if somebody, suppose somebody wants to attract money, he has to behave as if he had that money which he wants to attract. So, it's like belief. You have belief that you have that kind of money. So belief has lie in it. So when you believe that lie, that you have 200 crores in your bank, and if you act as if you have 200 crores, you will get 200. You cannot say, if this happens, I will be happy. You have to be happy, then that will happen. That's the people have that vicious circle. They never get what they want because they think, if this happens, I will be happy. And the biggest disease people have is more, M-O-R-E. So whatever they get, I want more. So what happens is, whatever they have, they are not happy with that. And that unhappiness continues. So they will always get something which they are not happy with. So if somebody wants to attract a lot of things which he wants to attract in his life, first thing is he should be having gratitude about what he has. He has two legs, he has hands, he has ears, he has eyes. No, he should be gratitude, having gratitude for that. And then he will get something which he wants to, he is aspiring for. So same applies for money. Okay. Other thing is, the biggest mistake people do is they try very hard to get money. Again, it's the biggest mistake. Can somebody try very hard to fall asleep? You cannot try very hard to fall asleep. You cannot do it. If you try very hard to fall asleep, you will never fall asleep. And that is what happens with people who try very hard to get money and they never get money. One should have complete belief and faith that there is huge abundance in the universe. And like Dhirubhai Ambani used to say, I walk on the road, I see notes lying on the road. And jisme himmat hai, uski Bombay mein kimmat hai. Jisme himmat hai, uski Bombay mein kimmat hai. Himmat hai, he will just pick up the notes and go. 3-4 days back there was a report in Times of India that there are about 3 lakh hawkers in Bombay. 3 lakh hawkers in Bombay, and nobody earns less than minimum 350 rupees per day. People are earning 20,000, 30,000 also per day, but it is 250 rupees also. 350 is minimum. Just imagine business in Siddhivinayak. In Siddhivinayak, if you go to Siddhivinayak temple, no bhikari collects less than 5,000 rupees a day. You will be shocked.
A day,
you will be shocked.
It's a good business.
It's a very, but nobody can. Tomorrow, if somebody goes and sits there, there will be a van, Maruti van, which will come, and that person will be put in that van, and that van will go to Haji Ali, that Darga. There are stones, they will be taken. He will be asked, who are you? Who has asked you to sit here? He says, I say, so they will actually cut your hand and say, now you sit with me. Like, it is my money. You sit there and you have to give the money to me. It's a big business. Monopoly. And the areas also are divided. Signals are divided. It is going up to the top. Yeah, you may not believe me. You stand, just sit, stand in front of, you know, there is a bhikari. You just stand near him and see what money he collects. And people who come to temple, they have earned a lot of money. Not everybody, but most of the people who come there to kind of wash their sins. And they feel that I should give something so that if they cheat somebody for 1 crore, they will give 1 lakh. And they will say, as if I have done, God, I have given you 1 lakh. That is why. So they are kind of bribing. You know, whatever this gold and this is going to God, it is because they want to bribe that God, sorry, I want 10 crore, but I have given you 10 lakhs. So please take care of that. So he is a partner in crime. Actually, God. Okay. So that is how it is. So if you stand near the bhikari, if you keep on watching, you will be able to count 5,000. And every Tuesday, no bhikari collects less than 20,000. But they are bhikari only. Because their mindset is poor. In Borivali, there was a beggar who died. And police came and they took their took him away. In the paper. And then they... No, more than that. That the money was there, that is one. Gaddi mein money was there, but the police wala now, they take everything they get. So he had that, what do you call, vessel, through which he used to, katora. So the police took that katora also. So, when he washed inside, there is a story coming. So when he took the katora at home, his wife said there is something different, not normal metal, it is something different. And that turned out to be platinum. And that was worth lakhs. So, for example, that katora was worth 50 lakhs and he was collecting 50 paisa in that. See the irony of the situation. He had 50 lakhs in his hand, but he was using it to collect 50 paisa. So, likewise, we all have, you know, unlimited potential to earn whatever we want. But mindset. See, again, what every action will, because the subconscious mind will understand action. Now, suppose we are going somewhere, so we immediately think, can I go by, if I go by taxi, it will be 30 rupees. If I walk, it is okay. So, it is a scarcity mentality. Then you cannot attract, you are repelling money. So, because you are telling subconscious mind that money is less, because I don't want to spend 30, because I value 30 rupees so much that it should be remaining in my pocket. So, you are actually conveying the signal to universe that I have less. So, we have to, every action should be conveying that I have more than enough. And things come. So that is the first principle. Otherwise, all we say that will go west. But unless we change the mindset, unless we change the thermostat to the different degree. Now we are on 23 AC. If we wanted 25, you have to set this 25. Then everything else will change. Okay. Now if you see, ideally you should have three photos in your home. Three photographs which I am requesting you to have. One photograph will be of 2,000 rupee note. You can have a 2,000 rupee and then laminate it and put it there. That also, that photo should be at your home. The other photo is that your own photo, smiling photo. And when you look at that photo, you have to say, I'm looking at the most powerful person on the earth. And money is coming easily to me and all that. So you should have your own photo, smiling, happy. Okay. And the third one is whichever God you believe in. Whatever, suppose you believe that your mother is God, so mother's photo should be there. If you think father is God or Ganpati, whatever, so that God, so these three photos should be there. So when you get up, look at that note. We believe in something, we call it God, but we believe in something, it can be anything. So whichever we believe that, yes, this thing I believe that this, or this universe, you know, if you see this, this universe also is, we give a name to, even the, we call it God, but it can be anything. This power. Anything, which you feel is the God. Like if you see,
if I feel like
Ah, why not? Very good. In fact, we are, if you look at God, the statue which is there in the temple, which is man-made, but he is God-made. So I respect God, it's okay, but I should respect him also. All the creation of God, all the human beings are creations of God. So their God is there. You see flower, you see river, you see anything, mountain, sun, these are God's creations. So the God is more there than maybe some other. But that is a symbol that we take this stone and we say this is God because we are looking at that as a God. But when you just look up in the sky and don't see anything else, keep looking in the sky for some time, then you will understand what is God. That is God, which cannot be measured, which cannot be controlled, which cannot be seen with naked eyes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. See, we feel that. Yes, absolutely.
So that is a symbol of abundance.
Abundance, unlimited. Unlimited. See, actually when we are living, we need 550 liters of oxygen every day. Otherwise, we will go in coma. And to get 550 liters of oxygen, we need 11,000 liters of air. That is the condition. But we don't doubt that oxygen will come from somewhere. Do we doubt that tomorrow will I get oxygen? Will I be able to get next breath? Will I have oxygen? So I think we believe it is there. But we don't believe the same thing for money. We think, will the money come next month?
Until now, I didn't know that we need so much of
food. Yeah, we need so. And in fact, if you see Salman Khan, Ajay Devgan, all these people, they have farmhouses out of Bombay. Because Salman and his family, virtually every week, they go to Panvel to breathe clean air. And his farmhouse, Arpita farm, it is in jungle. I have gone there. Total jungle. And if you breathe the air there, you will feel the difference. You breathe the air at Bombay Central Station and there is the difference. And they go there because no money can buy that. He cannot buy that. He can have AC, but he cannot buy that air. So they actually, Ajay Devgan goes every month, whole family goes there. Salman, the Shahrukh goes to Alibag. He had that controversy a few days back. So they go to the places to breathe clean air. Because if your body doesn't get clean air, you are going to be...
It's all
about creation. Concrete jungle. Concrete jungle.
Yeah, we have to believe the last one.
Yeah, we have to believe that this is the God and, you know, and this ultimate power, and this ultimate power, see, if you see the line, the ultimate power is making me rich and prosperous. It is making me rich and prosperous. It will make me rich and prosperous, nahin. Because it has to be, see, the biggest mistake we do is, we ask something from God in future tense. So, asking something from God is a big blunder. Because you don't have to ask, you have to just thank him. So people don't understand the meaning of prayer. So if you have to ask, he is not a God. So you go to temple and give 2 rupees that take care of my chappal. So do we believe in him? That you are not believing with your chappal also. So you have to believe in God, and when you go to the temple, whatever you want, suppose you want to buy Mercedes, you have to go inside the temple and say, God, thank you in advance that you have given me Mercedes. If you doubt will short circuit the mind. So if you doubt the God will say, go to hell, I will not give you. If suppose somebody doubts his spouse is good also, he will go and stray. Because he will say, my wife is suspecting me, let me rather have affair out. So if somebody goes to God and says, God, please do it. And then we talk about, I will give you this, I will give you that. That is again a big nonsense. God must be getting very angry. You will give me coconut. Who has made that? You will give me gold. God wants gold. He has given. What we can bribe God with is, I will go and wipe out somebody's tears. I will go and help somebody. I will go and help somebody in need without expecting anything in return. That is what you can tell God. God will be happy and he will be obliged. He will say, thank you very much, I will come for you. Otherwise, this gold and jewels, that is nothing. It is stone for him. What is there? But they want, in some politicians were thinking of having gold seat for Sai Baba in Shirdi. Sai Baba lived like this, but we didn't like, suppose Sai Baba is alive today. Even Sai Baba comes himself and says, don't do it, they will not listen to him. Because they are not interested in Sai Baba, they are interested in politicizing the whole issue and saying, I have done something
wrong. His whole life was, he has acted as a
fakir. And they want to make. In fact, this movie also, actually, that guy Arnab Goswami said, this movie is very good, Padmavati, for Rajput pride. It is actually talking about Rajput pride. And any Rajput should be proud that this movie, there was somebody like Padmavati in our, it was myth or reality, I don't know. But he said the movie is so good. And these own people, they are killing the, throwing the baby along with the bathwater. Because they want to create controversy, nothing else. There is no reason. In fact, Arnab, he saw that movie because he showed it to him. He challenged, you watch the movie and say, what is the, one frame is not wrong. One dialogue is which you will not be able to pinpoint. Sanjay Leela Bhansali is not a child, he knows. what to say, what not to say, what can aggravate. So before releasing, they are creating problem. Before watching the movie, I am saying it is bad. Anyway, so these are the three photos one should have, and then you will start attracting. And this photo, this God photo below that, ideally your mother is the biggest God. So you can put her photo, and you know, it is, I'm receiving that money, that abundance. See, now what, you know, there is a story where one group of people, they were going in desert, and one person somehow lost his way. So he was away from his group, and he didn't know where to go. It was all desert. So he was totally lost, and he was very much thirsty. He didn't have water to drink and nothing to eat. So he was on the verge of death, and he was so desperate what to do. Suddenly he found a hand pump. In the middle of the desert, he found a hand pump. The hand pump, he went there and he thought that is good, now I will get water. So he went near the hand pump. So there was a glass of water filled with water on the hand pump, and there was a note that you have two options. One is drink this glass of water. Other option is you put this glass of water in the hand pump and you will get unlimited water. If you drink this, hand pump will not give you a single drop. So whatever glass you have, you will have that, and that's all. But if you put this water in the hand pump will give you million liters of water. So now the choice is, that is a note written there. Now what you will do? Right. Now again, this is one more thing one has to understand. All the people who are rich in this world, they have taken the risk. Higher the risk, richer you are. The more we shun the risk, the, you know, people will not be rich. One cannot be rich if he doesn't take risk. Stock market is also there, but in life also. I mean, this case, somebody will say, let me drink or finish it or what, who will think about that? As is rightly pointed out. But that person who was there, he said, let me take a chance. Because he didn't see the problem, he thought of possibilities. So he said, let us see this possibility, what happens. And then he puts that water in the pump. And then he starts pumping that pump, nothing comes out. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, he's desperate. He thinks, hey, what happened? I put this water also and there is nothing coming out. And then he slightly hears some voice. And then the voice becomes big noise and the water starts flowing in, flowing out. And he gets unlimited water. Then he drinks to his heart's content. And there is one more thing which is written. After you are through, again you say, there is a button, you once you push that, it will stop. And again glass of water, you keep it there. And the note remains there. Now again it stopped.
It is a priming.
So see the case. Now issue is, then he was very happy after having drunk the water and he was going. Suddenly he came back and below that note he wrote, it works. It works. Because somebody next who will come, he should not have that dilemma. But in real life also similar things happen. We get opportunity. That opportunity can take you down or take you up.
We doubt whether it works or not.
Whether it works. But for that real life opportunity, I will say, it works if you work. It works if you work. You give any, he knew Dhirubhai Ambani very well. So you give any challenge to Dhirubhai Ambani, he used to be happy. He used to take, never as a stumbling block, he used to see as a stepping stone. So like Dhirubhai Ambani used to say, somebody gives you lemon, you make an apple juice and let people wonder what happened. How he made apple juice? So that is Dhirubhai's dimag. So he will not make lemon juice, he will make apple juice with some kalakandi jugad. And people will keep on thinking how it came. And then people will buy lemon in the hope that it will give apple juice. And it will not give apple juice. Only Dhirubhai knows how to get apple juice. So that is why he became rich. That is why Mukesh is the richest person on the earth. Anyway. So desert and magic water, you understand the concept. In real life also, every step you will get challenges. And Dhirubhai Ambani used to say, challenges are disguised opportunities. And opportunities will never come as I am opportunity. It will come as I am problem. So people who run away from problem, they are actually running away from solution. Because the only way you can win the race is not running away from problem, running towards the problem. So Dhirubhai Ambani, Ratan Tata, all these people actually ran towards the problem. They never ran away from problem, and that is why they made it big. And they have, see, every success story is a big failure story. But people see the pinnacle of success, but a kind of, you know, that iceberg. So success is that top, but there is huge failure, but nobody sees that because nobody is interested in that. In fact, what happens is, most of the time, if you see the stories written, any book written by somebody, he's a successful guy, he failed and he became successful. But nowhere somebody has written a book that I am failure, I have failed, even today I am failure. There is no book like this. Show me. Show me a book where the person is a big failure and he remains, he is failure only. Because one cannot be a big failure and not be successful. You can only be a small failure and become failure. There is nothing like big failure. Big failure is equal to success. Big failure cannot be failure. Big failure has to be success because continuous and consistent effort. Now, if I give a glass, maybe bucket full of water, and there is a stone, and if I ask you to break that stone with that bucket full of water, is it possible? No. But if you put that, there is a on Shankar Bhagwan ki pinda, there is, you know, one drop it. So that water, if it falls under on the stone, drop by drop, it will break the stone. So consistency. So the first few drops they fall, they don't do anything to the rock, they don't get disheartened. They keep on falling on the rock and the rock breaks. So that has to be there, you know, one should keep on trying. So it works, if we work. See, basically money and finance is like matchstick. You burn the matchstick and you know till when you have to keep it. After a point you have to throw it. It's like stock market also. Stock market people lose money not when they buy, they lose money when they sell. Or they make money when they sell. So stock market will only be able to benefit you or rob you of money when you sell. So when to sell, when to leave that market, you should know. And people then creep, the market is bad, market is not bad. You kept on holding on that stick far too long. So that one has to understand when to let go of this stick. See, we have to be happy and reason will come along. That is the biggest thing. People want reason and then they want to be happy. So there, it will never happen that we have to be happy first and then the reasons will come. Okay, now basically, do we love money? Do you think all of us love money?
Yes.
All of us love money.
Many people don't.
Nahi? Matlab what? Again, example.
The thinking is money is bad, no. It will corrupt.
See, money, nothing is bad or good per se, its usage is good or bad. If you buy good thing with money, you buy bad thing with money, it is how you use it. The fire, you can have food cooked on it or you put your hand. Fire is impersonal, it will do what it does. You have to decide what you want out of it. But if we should give auto suggestion that I love money, we should, every step we should say I love money. But generally we don't love money because what happens, that will come to, but generally when people say when our jeb is garam, dimag is thanda. And jeb is garam, dimag is thanda. But jeb thanda, dimag garam. So we have to work as if our jeb is garam. So if your jeb is garam, your dimag will be thanda. You have to behave like a thanda man as if my jeb is garam. Because the moment your dimag becomes hot, the jeb will be empty. So anger is one word short of danger, things like that. No? Any extreme emotion will rob you of your rationality and you will lose that particular thing. So why Dhoni is successful? Because he is level-headed. He will never get excited with this and that. So jeb garam and dimag thanda. Now see, sound of money is very, very important. Now suppose we are not sitting here, all of you are looking at my side. There is a coin, there is a sound of coins falling from the last row, behind the last row. Everybody look around. And everybody, even he will check his own pocket. So that is the sound, power of sound of money. So which I talk to business schools, when I talk to the management students, that when you go to anybody, any of you doing business of any kind, you are selling aeroplane to chappal to aeroplane or whatever, when you talk to somebody about your business, the person who is sitting opposite you, he should hear the sound of money. You are selling say calendars. So you have to find out how he will save money. So when you talk that if you buy this, you will save 10 lakh rupees a year. The sound of money will make him excited and he will listen to you. Otherwise you say, I have a best product, I am best, I am this, he will say thank you. Money jeb mein jab hai paisa, log puchte to hai kaisa. Money has to, whatever you sell. So my request to all of you who are in business, that you have to monetize the benefit of your product or service. So if you use my product or service, you will not feel good because nobody bothers feeling good. How much money we will save or earn more? So if you tell that person that you will be able to gain this much, he is interested. So everything happens in this world for two principles, for selling or any business happens for pain or gain. Reducing the pain or increasing the gain. So either you reduce the pain or increase the gain. So your product, how it is going to reduce the pain and increase the gain in monetary terms? Like in Trishul, Amitabh Bachchan goes and he doesn't meet him, Sanjay Kumar. So Amitabh says, aapne mujhse 5 minute na milke, aapka 5 lakh ka nuksan kiya. He monetizes the benefit of meeting him. He doesn't say, main aapko kyun mil raha hun. He says, aapne mujhse 5 minute nahi mila, aapka nuksan ho gaya 5 lakh. So when he says 5 lakh, Sanjay Kumar calls him inside. So that is how when business, we should talk about the sound of money. People should hear sound of money. Now we are hearing that sound of thok thok come down. See, basically we have fear. Generally we money doesn't come because we have fear of losing. Fear of unknown. Because 90% and more times fear is like fake evidence appearing real. Fake evidence appearing real. It is not reality, but we think it will happen. Like I went to Madhuri Dikshit's home. People are thinking, how can she talk to you? Why she will talk to you even? Who are you? But I just went and I asked the secretary to, and we could meet. Because we have that perception that why she will meet me. But it is better to try and fail than not try at all. So I believe in that. Go and meet whom. If you want me to meet Ratan Tata, I will go to Ratan Tata. No, onus is on him to say no to me. Na? Why should I bother about what he should do? If I think about what he should do, what I will think about myself. Munna bhai bolta na, agar hum logo bail ka sochenge, matlab hal hum chalayenge to bail kya chalayega? To hal to bail ko chalane ka. So likewise, let the other party think what he will do. The burning coal is, there are training programs where they have that coal and walk.
Firewalking.
But once you walk, you feel it is okay.
That time only, then next day again you will feel.
Because it's momentary. But most of things are imagined, because we think that walking on the fire, how it is possible. People eat burning this cotton also. But it is all imagined, that they think that it will create problem. But people walk. I have walked. I was having a lot of, I was thinking it will be, but we can just walk it out like that. So once we walk, then we know this is nothing. So again, success, there are three steps. And where people go wrong, let me tell you. First thing is knowing. So people know this is what it is. So whatever I have told you, I am going to tell you today, that is knowing. It is not going to help. Unless you go to the third step, this will not bring money in your life. So knowing something, people know that I should get up early in the morning and exercise. So nothing changes. Because I know. But what should be the next step?
Do.
So one should be doing. But by only doing, again the success doesn't come. You have to keep on doing it again and again and again. And then you achieve perfection. And then there is the achievement stage. That is where you become successful. So anything you want to achieve in life, knowing is nothing, doing is something. But doing it consistently again and again, in spite of lot of failures, then you will go to achievement state. Success is going from failure to failure without losing the enthusiasm. So enthusiasm, if you see the spelling, last four letters are IASM. Enthusiasm, IASM. So that IASM is I am sold myself. In the sense, I am sold out on this concept. I believe in this concept. So whatever happens, I will go for it. But I will go and complete this again and again and again and again. Dhirubhai Ambani always quoted, he used to say, you try something for 10 times, if you fail, try for 20 times. If you fail, try for 40 times. Challenge the failure. Because failure is actually challenging you. Who blinks first? But if you believe in that, there is something in this, this is going to work. Then people don't lose, they stop trying. You ask, you know, if you look at our own life also, we have stopped trying after a point. We think, enough. I tried so many times, now enough. So that is why foreign countries, they are ahead, because they value failure. The people, when they have a drink in the night, they say, I failed so many times. He says, what? I failed so many times. Here, failure is treated as plague. He says, no, I went and it happened, though he must have failed. So we treat failure as something wrong. And that is the biggest problem, because failure is success turned inside out. So one should be ready to fail. In the doing state, a lot of times one will fail. But if he keeps on doing and without losing enthusiasm, he will achieve. Now, biggest money rule, the people who have money make the rule. Now, what is the biggest money rule? People who have money, they will make the rule. Now, please understand one thing, which in the movie Guru, Maniratnam said, that Guru movie, Dhirubhai Ambani's movie, where there was a dialogue, all the rules which are there in this world are there to make poor remain poor. That poor person should remain poor. Because this class, elitist class, they don't want the poor person to come there. And that is, so you have to break the rule. So all the people who have money, they will make the rule. You can't come to this club. Now they are saying this Chaiwala, how he can become PM? Why can't the Chaiwala become PM? So you have to be born in Nehru family to become PM. So what is your credibility? So we should be proud that somebody like Chaiwala, who is nobody, he became PM. One should be, we should be proud that there is somebody like him. Not somebody's father was big. That is, what is your credential? Because somehow you came, you were born there. So we have to value that. And that is why the people who rise like Narendra Modi and Dhirubhai Ambani, they fought against the rules. And they made themselves irreplaceable. And that is why they went ahead. Because if you go by I tell somebody to do something, you will say, they will not allow. So they will never allow. What is the point? In Khalnayak, there is
find a way.
Actually, if you find a way around or way through, you break it and go inside. In the movie Khalnayak, there is a title song, Nayak Nahi Khalnayak Hume, Sanjay Dutt. So there is a tremendous song, again, Anand Bakshi. So, usme ek wording hai, mangi jo cheez nahi mili, karta mein kya abad chheen li. What a thought. Jo cheez mangi wo nahi mili, karta mein kya, tumhe chheen li. There are two ways. Either you just accept it and go home, otherwise chheen lo. And all the people who have actually become something in life, they have done that. They have refused to accept that nonsense. I will do it. Apna kaam banta bhaad mein gayi janta. In a positive sense. Not in the negative sense. Don't do something which will hurt people. But I want to do it, I want to do it. That's all. So this guy who was a big painter and he died poor. So you may be good at your art. You may be good at managing. Earning money is easy. Managing money is difficult. There are so many film stars also who died poor. They got a lot of money, but they didn't know how to manage that money and they died poor. So again, these are rules that how to manage them. And money is a good slave and a bad master. If somebody keeps money as a master, he will always be in trouble. See, other thing is, you will be happy as far as money is concerned. When you are not working for money, money is working for you. So when money works for you, he is a slave for you. So that time you will make money. Today, Mukesh Ambani must be sitting at home and maybe 1.50 lakh people are working for him. So money is making them work. And the person is treated as rich only when he doesn't work, his money works. And we are all treated poor because we have to go out of home, do something to earn money. The moment you decide that I will not go out of home for rest of my life and money will keep on coming, that is when you are rich. Now Chetan Bhagat, money is coming in. He is writing books, sitting at home, money is coming. That is rich. Lata Mangeshkar, she has sung the song, the money is coming. So that is poor. Person, his body is working for money. It is most dangerous situation to be in. Because the moment your body stops, you will die of hunger. It is so dangerous. So one has to make sure that he does something, some property, some asset, which will start earning money for him. Even if he doesn't go out, he will get money. See, in the world, they say 1% people have 97% wealth in the world. But in Mumbai, 1% people have 22% wealth. 1% people in Bombay have 22% wealth. I read in Times of India a few days back. Few people earn crores, and crore people earn few. So that is how it is. Everybody has 24 hours a day. So we cannot, God is very kind. So he is not saying, Mukesh, you will have 48 hours and you will have 20 hours. So everybody is having 24. But what we do in those 24 hours is important. And in that, what we do means, we have to try to work 24/7 on creating asset which will work for us. We are trying to work to earn money. That is the biggest blunder. We have to work to earn money to create asset as early as possible so that asset will give me money. So for example, Himanshu should work so that he will buy a flat which will give him 50,000 rent, and his objective should be earn so much that I should buy a flat. Then I am sitting idle and money is coming. He keeps on earning, keeps on getting money and spends. He's poor, zero. So everybody should work for that. And he should have a goal that by this age, I will be financially free. That after that age, my money will work for me, I will not work. Okay, like the money. See, there are three types of money problems. Let us understand, we will be falling in one of them. Three types of money problems. Actually, we don't work for the solution, we only pray. That's why God is such a big entity. Because people want to go there and say, God, kuch karo. One day, okay, you take care. We want to put it in his plate. Because God will not work unless you work. Because he cannot come and do it for you. We have to do it. They will cut level. But most of the people are here. Why temples are full? And Mangalwar ko temple, I don't understand. Mangalwar ko Ganpati hai, Budhwar ko nahi hai. So why you would want Tuesday only? I just don't get it. But if somebody somewhere said Tuesday, then somebody said Saturday for Hanuman, then Thursday for Sai Baba. And people are following that blindly. Go on Friday to Shirdi and have a proper darshan. Tel ka bahut chalta. In fact, I went to a temple that day, somebody was actually putting that milk packet above the Shankar. I felt like telling him, God will be there with me, it's a poor child, you know, he will get, but they will not, he will get angry on me. He will say, I will do that also, why you are coming in between? And people are very sensitive about these matters. Huh? They will get angry. In fact, I told somebody, why you are buying this garland? With this money, go. He said, I will do both. Don't tell me that. I will buy a garland and give it to God. And you are saying that poor child, I will give him money also. I said, okay, do that now. What can I do? Okay, the second type is they work for a temporary solution. See, actually, if you see, the person who is on the road, who begs, gets money, he eats and he sleeps, zero. Next morning, again he gets up, he goes and begs, gets money, eats, drinks, sleeps, zero. So he is working for a day. There are some people in industrial area, they work for a week. They get salary on Thursday. They work for 6 days, they get salary on Thursday. Thursday they will drink and whole Friday they will be sleeping in hangover. Again, Saturday to Thursday they will work, they will get money, they will eat, drink, enjoy, khalas. So they are working for a week. So both these people, one day and week, what they are working for? Temporary. They are working for survival. Not even solution, survival. Aaj ka din kya baat khalas. Survival. Okay. Now people where the majority is, they work for a month. And at the end of the month they get money. That's all, because actually the person who is begging on the road, I'm sorry if it comes across as harsh, but the fact is, person is working for a month and begging on the road, there's a difference of one salary. Lot of people commit suicide. Why? Because they can't beg. The job has gone. Where the money will come? They'll commit suicide. So a person who is working for a job and a person who is begging on the road, one salary is a difference which is separating them. Because the moment a company thinks, don't come, thank you. And it doesn't have to be you are bad. Like suppose we are in pager company. Pager gets go out of fashion. Mobile comes, you are out. HFCL company closed down. Kodak, Nokia, 142 years old company. You are not required. So it is not that you have to be bad to be thrown out. Things change. So the salary class is most dicey, most dangerous. And they are working for survival, comfort, some satisfaction, that's all.
That is why one day they get pink sleep.
And they are shocked. And they don't know what. So again, one mistake, biggest mistake which I want to tell everybody is, the people work for maybe 20-25 years, then they are sacked or whatever happens, they leave the job and they start doing business. And they think they will succeed. They don't have business experience. They are working on somebody else's money. Working on somebody else's money and working on your own money is a different ball game altogether. So when they start doing business with their own money, they cannot survive. 2-3 years down the line, they make huge loss. They don't understand. And then again, they will go and join some job or do something else. Because money, because when they were working, they worked as an employee. They should have worked as an employer mindset. So wherever we work, I tell management graduates, where I go and talk to them about careers. So I tell them, work as an owner of the company. Don't work like an employee. So when you have that work owner mentality, when you will switch from job to business, you will be successful. But if you have an employer mentality, employee mentality, will never be successful. Well, you don't know what is employer. 8 Gadi dikha rahe. That day, there was a seminar where Auchat had come. He said, I employ UP boys in there because Marshan, he is Marshan. He says, I wanted to employ Marathi. Show me watch at 6 o'clock. I have to go. So that should not work. So they have to work as if it is my hotel and they will become successful. So this is, that was one case I have given. What happened is there was somebody who bought 1 lakh rupees, took a loan from Chopra. 1 lakh rupees, he took a loan from Mr. Chopra. And after 1 month, Mr. Chopra said, give my money. Then he went to Mr. Sippy and said, please give me 1 lakh rupees. And that 1 lakh rupees, he went and gave to Chopra. Chopra was happy. And he said, I'll give you after 1 month. So after 1 month, Sippy said, give my money. Then he again went to Chopra, I gave your money back last time. Please give me. And then he gave to Sippy. And then again after 1 month, Sippy, he kept on doing that. And it was the second situation, working for a temporary solution, which is a salary situation. So we earn, we spend zero. We earn minus spend zero. Actually, we earn minus invest is equal to spend. Earn minus invest is equal to spend. Then you will make an asset. Otherwise, it's gone. Now, one day what happened, this person was sitting in hotel. And suddenly, Chopra came. And he sat there. He said, kaise ho, kya ho? And after a few minutes, Sippy also came. On that time, he was not knowing kisse paisa liya, kisko dene ka. And then they spoke out, arre, mera har mahine mein aata hai. Then they understood ki ye ho chal raha. So this will go on till the time they find out. So this temporary solution can go out of the business anytime. Like, allopathic medicine also is a temporary solution. If there is some problem, allopathy will only treat the symptom. They will stop the symptom. You are feeling this, it is stopped. But inside what is happening, nobody knows. So it has to be done from inside. You know, people say incurable disease. So incurable is incurable. You have to cure from inside. Likewise, all the diseases have to be cured from inside. They cannot be cured from outside. So now, third one is a permanent solution. Go to the root cause of the problem. Why this is a problem? What is the problem? If my money flow stops, I am in trouble. So what should I do for that? So I should have something which will keep on giving me money, whatever happens, if I work on, don't work. So what should I do for that? Then maybe I buy a flat and put it on rent. So that money will keep. So should I work for this or something else? So people should work for creating an asset which will keep on giving them money, and they will be hassle free. They don't have to worry about where the money will come from. So, you know, today's talk, I want to request you only one thing. Work for creating an asset which will give you money without you working for it. Then you are financially free. Otherwise, you will be under the trouble always. You are under that cloud that anything can happen. And people consider money as a barometer for success. That is a fact. Believe it or not, that is how it is. See, it is very important also. It is like the milk to the newborn. It is very like oxygen we require. It is very important also. Now, in the currency, as this word is taken from a Greek word, and the meaning of that Greek word is to run. So, currency has to run, the money has to flow. If you stop the blood flow circulation, that particular part will be waste. Likewise, if you stop giving money, you will stop receiving money. And in fact, the proportion is so big, the giving and receiving is in higher proportion. So, you help somebody who cannot help you in cash or kind, you will get multiple money back from some other source. But if I give money to him, expecting him to help me sometime, it is not, I am not giving, I am investing. And someday I will take it from him. So there are a lot of crooks I have seen. When they meet you, they give you so much that you will be under their pressure. They will give you so much that you will be shocked. And after that, they will ask money from you. So they will spend, say, 1 lakh rupees on you. And they will say, yeah, I am in trouble. Can you give me 10 lakh rupees? And you are so much in pressure that he spent so much money on me, you will give 10 lakhs and it is gone. So that is also one has to be careful about, but that is how it is. So it cannot be only that. That is strategy. I have seen a lot of people doing that. Earn the trust and break it. First earn the trust and then break it in a big way. Most people do that. And actually the people, that is why I always say, Ati vinayena durta lakshanam. Ati vinayena durta. Person is behaving too good with me, I get suspicious. What is there in me? Why is being so good to me? So there is some ulterior motive, unless he is God. Getting too close, then you, the person starts smelling. Like tomorrow Aishwarya also might smell. People will say Aishwarya looks good, but maybe near and anyway. Now there is a case where a man, he falls in love with somebody, a girl, beautiful girl, and they are going around, and they want to get married. And after a few years, he joins a new job, and he meets one widow there. And she is very rich, because that job, the owner's wife, and the owner is died, is no more there. And the wife is managing the show. And that wife, she doesn't have one eye also. Not so good looking and aged also. But she also starts falling in love with this man. And he also falls in love with her. Now he is in dilemma, whom to marry. Whom should he marry? A good, beautiful, his age girl, who is poor, ordinary. And should he marry somebody who is one-eyed, widow, for money? He loves her also and loves this poor girl also, but he is in dilemma, whom to marry. So he goes to his friend and says, what should I do? I love this girl also, I love this woman also, because I feel she is also wrong, her husband died. And she has money also, but she cannot enjoy her life. Now this girl may get a good husband also, but I love her also, from childhood we are together also. So he is in dilemma. So the friend says, ideally you should work for love. Money kya paisa aayega jayega, you can earn money. You should marry for love. You love that girl from childhood, you should marry her. He said, good, yaar. I was also thinking, good, you underlined the whole concept. So I will marry her. Then that friend asked, please give me her number. We don't know. So he wanted to go back. So that is what money is all about. Okay, actually, when we say, do we love money, it is again subjective. We love our money which is in our pocket. We don't love money which people have. Like suppose you see somebody in Mercedes, your own friend who was roaming around with you in buses. Now he suddenly bought Mercedes. So we do, there must be some kuch jhol kiya hoga. He is in custom, he is an octroi, paisa khaya hoga. So actually you are cursing the money. So we don't love that money. So money gets angry with you. I say, how many people? So we should not curse. The way whatever he has earned, how we are supposed to get into that. So people hate money which others have. Now there was a man who was taking his bag out of his home. The bag was very heavy. So he dragged the bag up to the door and he was on the door. The half bag was outside the door, half was inside the door. And he was trying to push it out. He wanted to take the bag out. Suddenly the neighbor comes. He says, I will help you. And he also helps him. But the bag doesn't move. Why?
Pushing out and that one is pushing.
So the man from outside is pushing inside. And he is pushing outside. So after some time they decided what is happening, why it is not moving, because they are working against each other. So when we say ki, I hate his money, I love my money, you will remain there. So two forces are opposing money. One force is saying I hate, one force saying I love. So your money position will not change. So we should, whenever we think of money of anybody, we should be happy for him. In fact, when we give money to somebody, suppose I am giving 500 rupees to, I ate some ice cream and I am giving 200 rupees. I should be saying inside that this money should help him. And I should tell myself, suppose I am giving a 500 rupee note, I should tell myself that don't worry, go. Tumhare bade bhai ban mere paas aane wale, go. To 2000 rupee aane wala hai. And udhar bhi tere bade bhai ban ko leke ja. So this 100 rupee note should take big brother to him also and to me also. Hum log bole, yaar, main isko do. The people who bargain, they will never be moneyed. They will always remain there. The people who bargain, they come from a scarcity mentality. You say, here, yellow. Never bargain. In fact, there is one person in Manjur, there is one DO. He told me that in LIC. He told me that we should, anybody is asking 100, you give 100 without asking. Because that person inside, he will feel so good, he will get 1000. But the moment you start bargaining, you are actually telling the universe that I don't have enough. And universe will say, tathastu. You will have to bargain always, because you will always have lesser money than you have to pay. So never ideally bargain. Now suppose you have a hot water and you put cold water in that, it will be normal. So likewise, these two forces should not work against. Loving money and hating money should not work against each other. Jaise jeb mein jab hai paisa, log puchte hai kaisa. See, this is how to, you laugh, people will laugh at you. You weep alone. And you feast, your home is crowded. And agar aap fasting pe ho, duniya bolegi thank you very much. Yeah, that is what. Actually, disappearance of friends is directly proportional to disappearance of money. Friends also will vanish. In fact, your bad times will tell you, who are your friends. Success has many fathers, and failure is orphan. So failure is orphan. See, now money will change your personality also. You go to a mall with 1 lakh rupees in your pocket, your walk will be different. You go to a mall with 100 rupees in pocket, your walk will be different. So that money in pocket actually can change the personality of a person. The way Vinod Khanna, the way he walks, that is his personality. Because the way he looks, he was walking like that. But somebody other, like, he has to believe that I have a lot of money or I have. In fact, it was, I read somewhere that, how a man can impress a opposite sex, the girl. So either he should have a lot of money, or he should be drop dead gorgeous like Vinod Khanna, or he should have good sense of humor. So it is not only good looks. There are people like Ramesh Sippy married Kiran Joneja, Miss World. So unless you have intelligence, you will be able to attract somebody else. Now you must have seen that ad where this middle class mother and daughter, they are going in 5-star and people are looking suspiciously at them. But the daughter walks confidently because she had money. And mother was thinking, kaha leke ja rahi. But daughter had money, so she went inside. And now there is a love story. The girl says, do you love me? The boy says, of course I do, sweetheart. The girl says, will you marry me then? It's a gender subject. Now he says, let us not change the subject. In the sense, love and marriage, they don't go together. Are you getting me?
Love is natural.
So marriage can be or cannot be. So likewise, it cannot be contradictory. So when you love money, it has to be there with you. It cannot be you are loving money and not coming. Okay. See, the people are not comfortable talking about money. See, in business, people talk about their product or service and they explain what it is, how it is good and all that. And you must have experience, the people who are selling something. When it comes to asking for money, people are tongue-tied. They cannot close the sale. Why like that? So we are not comfortable talking about money. Give me the money, we don't talk about. So that hesitation is always there. People don't talk about school fee will not go down. We all talk about it. I mean, all these solutions, all these problems, the solutions are there in movies, which I will come and tell you how people should be able to talk. Business dealing, closure is about money. Whatever business dealing you are doing, well, unless you get the money, it is not closed. It will keep on going on. See, in the movie Diwar, Amitabh Bachchan goes to Madan Puri and says, I will give you this information and you will get this gold. And Vijay, this guy, Madan Puri says, you have to sit with me. Because agar ye mazak nikla, tum hasne ke liye zinda nahi rahoge. ऐसे डायलॉग है सलीम जावे एंड अमिताभ से अगर आपने इसे मजाक समझा तो जिंदगी भर रोओगे व्हाट अ डायलॉग एंड देन दिस बोलता है आप तुम मेरे साथ ही रहोगे क्योंकि जब तक मुझे सोना नहीं मिलता तुम मेरे साथ ही रहोगे अमिताभ बोलता मंजूर है दे आर सिटिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ ईच अदर एंड सडनली द फोन कम्स एंड द पर्सन सेज कि साहब सोना मिल गया एंड देन ही कीप्स द फोन डाउन एंड द मोमेंट एंड ही सेज तुम्हारी इन्फॉर्मेशन सही थी हमें सोना मिल गया इफ यू वॉच द मूवी अगेन सलीम जावेद दे आर गॉड्स ऑफ बिजनेस ऑल्सो They are not only movie, they are gods of business. They know, they knew how to do business. The moment he says, aapka sona mil gaya, he gets some, Amitabh gets. Amitabh says, ki aapka kaam ho gaya hai. Abhi mujhe mera paisa mil jana chahiye. See, matter of asking for money, when your work is done, give me my money. Then Madan Puri says, ki ab to sona mujhe mil gaya. Ab main tumhare paise na du to. Then Amitabh says, bachpan mein maine kahani suni thi. Ek aadmi ko sone ka anda dene wali murgi mili. उसने सोचा क्यों ना उसका पेट फाड़ के सारे अंडे आज ही ले तो आपके सारे आपको सारे अंडे आज चाहिए या बस उधर रुक जाता हूँ मदन पुरी नहीं मैं तो मजाक कर रहा था अमिताभ से मैं जानता था मजाक मतलब काइंड ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस कि मजाक कर मैं जानता हूँ एंड देन ही गेट्स द बैग एंड गिव्स द मनी टू एंड ही सेज अगली इन्फॉर्मेशन कब मिलेगी मतलब जल्दी टेक्स द बैग एंड गोस एंड दैट सीन एक्चुअली टेल्स यू हाउ टू आस्क फॉर मनी सी इफ यू आर कॉन्फिडेंट दैट व्हाट ही इज पेइंग You are giving him worth and more than that to him. Then you will be confident. I am giving you, you are paying me 100 rupees, I am giving you worth 101. Then you will say, give me the money.
Because that, then you will not have that self-doubt.
You should be,
you know, you have learned.
You are the best. In fact, in the book which Bill Gates has written, which everybody should read, Business at the Speed of Thought, the first book which he wrote. In that book, he wrote very good thing, which every businessman should know. He wrote that whenever customer perceives the value of the product more than the price he will buy. I am paying 100 is what I pay is price, what I get is value. So when you pay 60 lakh rupees for Mercedes, the value may be crores. Because when I go with Mercedes, go in Mercedes somewhere, what deal I am cracking, that may be worth 1000 crores. So for me, that 60 lakh Mercedes is nothing compared to 1000 crores. So I have seen Taj Lands End, there is a White and Maclay whiskey brand. The whole bottle, they are charging 3.5 lakhs. People discuss, they drink something, they get the full bottle, they drink and half the bottle is still pending and they walk off. Parcel bana ke to nahi bolte. Because they discuss 500 crores there. So what is 3.5 lakhs? They'll walk and the bottle is gone. Parcel leka. Kidhar hota tha pehla parcel. Because again that is a scarcity mentality. Kondi ek bottle aur le lenge. Rehne do isko. Take it off. Now, in this movie, Diwar also, there is one more concept where Amitabh Bachchan never picks up the money thrown by anybody else. And he demands his money. Wo boot polish karta hai. Khone ke baad wo paisa fekta hai. Bolta hai, saab, main bheek nahi maang raha hu, paisa uthake do. Main kaam kar raha hu, I am not begging. Beggar ko bheek diya jata hai, paisa fekta kya hai. And now, that movie talks about attitude. He is an 8-year-old boy polishing shoes of somebody who has come in car like Mercedes. Bade bade do log hai, Mercedes mein suited, booted. Wo time Mercedes nahi tha, jo bhi brand tha bada. And then he nobody फटा हुआ कपड़ा and he gets up and says पैसा उठा के दो and then इफ्तिकार says ये लड़का हमेशा बूट पॉलिश नहीं करेगा ये जिंदगी में आगे जाए and that is how life is if we believe he believed I'm big I'm bigger than you and he becomes bigger than them वन डे इट हैपन दैट इफ्तिदार सेज अरे सारा काम तुम्ही कर रहे हो, मुझे आराम करने दो, यू टेक केयर ऑफ दिस चेयर एंड ही इज आस्क्ड टू टेक केयर ऑफ द चेयर, ही बिकम्स बॉस ऑफ देम बिकॉज ही बिलीव्ड इन हिमसेल्फ कि आई एम बिग, आई मे बी फुट पॉलिश वाला नाउ बट आई एम बिगर देन एनीबॉडी एल्स, एंड दैट एटीट्यूड पीपल शुड हैव, एक्ट एज इफ यू आर द बेस्ट. पैसे नहीं दैट टाइम ऑल्सो गिव्स आज भी फेक यू पैसे उड़ा. ओके नाउ सो पीपल हैव प्रॉब्लम दे गो टू थेरापिस्ट एंड ऑल दैट. सो नाउ देर वॉज वन पर्सन वॉन्ट गोज टू अ डॉक्टर एंड डॉक्टर सेज दैट आपका प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व कर दूंगा, 10 सिटिंग लगेगा, आई विल हैव टू सिट विद यू फॉर 10 टाइम दैट योर माइंड प्रॉब्लम विल सॉल्व आउट एंड एवरी सिटिंग विल बी कॉस्टिंग 1000. द पर्सन सेज आपका प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व हो गया, मेरा प्रॉब्लम लग गया. सो दैट इज लाइक डॉक्टर दैट इज अगेन अ स्कैंडल व्हाट यू से मे बी अ रैकेट व्हिच कीप्स ऑन गेटिंग मनी फ्रॉम पीपल. पकड़ के लोग ये सीन है. नाउ यू कैन गो एंड मे बी आई विल सेंड इट टू इफ यू वॉन्ट इन यूट्यूब देर इज देर ऑल. इफ यू गो टू माई चैनल प्रशांत सावंत चैनल यूट्यूब चैनल देर ऑल दी सीन्स आर देर यू हैव अ लुक एट दोज दैट इज हाउ इट. नाउ व्हाट आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू इन नो व्हाइल क्लोजिंग द थिंग, वेन यू लुक एट यूर पर्स यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट वॉट इज देर इन द पर्स. आइडियली देर शुड बी मनी और थिंग्स विच आर कनेक्टेड टू मनी. सपोज टेक अ एग्जाम्पल दैट यू आर स्टेइंग वट एवर फ्लैट यू आर स्टेइंग टूडे यू आर स्टेइंग देर विथ योर फैमिली. You have exactly similar flat next door, same flat, same furnished flat next door, your own flat. Now somebody, some relative of yours comes and he stays with you. आपको लगता है एक हफ्ते में जाएगा, लेकिन हफ्ता, दस दिन, पंद्रह दिन, दो महीना, तीन, he is not going. Now what you will do? And you cannot say go because he is close also. Now what you will do? You have one more flat, same next door. Now this guy is not going. That is one, but you cannot ask him to go there. He will feel offended. ये कर सकते बट अदर व्हाट इज अदर ऑप्शन. वन इज वील आस्क हिम रिक्वेस्ट हिम टू गो उधर ही रहो, वो अपना ही फ्लैट है, दैट इज वन. व्हाट नेक्स्ट, व्हाट अदर ऑप्शन वी कैन डू? वेयर यू आर स्टेइंग, नाउ वी आर स्टेइंग द सेम फ्लैट नेक्स्ट फ्लैट. हां वी कैन शिफ्ट राइट ना. सो व्हाट आई विल से, व्हाट यू विल से, फॉरगेट इट, लेट हिम स्टे हियर, वी विल शिफ्ट हियर. सो यू एंड योर फैमिली विल शिफ्ट टू द नेक्स्ट फ्लैट. ओके नाउ कमिंग टू द आवर सिचुएशन, पर्स, आवर पर्स, आवर पर्स शुड नॉट हैव एनीथिंग व्हिच डजंट हैव एनी वैल्यू. Your parking ticket or something with your ATM,
many a time you keep it
there. So what happens is when your papers which are useless, the money goes out. The money says, let me go out. Clutter. Because his money are clutter. He is more interested in this than me. So he'll go out. That is one thing. So please, on Saturday, you refurbish, you replenish your bag. Check. Other thing is money. Now, anybody has 5-6 notes? Can somebody show me? So how you count those?
Yes.
But how you, that is also right way. 2000, 1500 loud. So how you count? You count please.
Like this.
Unko karne do. Let us see. You are doing like this. Okay. double. Scan. Ye mental scan. Ye aapne bola hai leke jao. Double aayega. So now he was counting like this. Like this. He was counting like this, right? See, ideally money should be, when people count, people count like this. So you are asking money to go. Even aapne jo kiya na, you are saying money to go there. So you have to take it like this and count like this. It will come to you. And it has to be always 2000, 1000. It cannot be ulta sulta.
It will go.
Other thing is this, now this is like this. Now this is like this. That is also not right. Money doesn't like it. So like you are, we all 4-5 you are sleeping here. Now you are sleeping ulta. So your feet is on my move. So I am not happy. So either we'll sleep together, like I will come this way. So it should like that. So it exactly same way it should be there. It will multiply. So these are the small ways where the money will multiply. And that photo which I said, that 2000 rupees photo, before going out of home, you look at that photo. And then today I am going to get barsat of this kind of notes. It will happen. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. All the best. Thank you.